everyone. John Rocha here with Dorian Parks, the social media manager of Collider and the new host and star of what?
Millennials Must Watch.
Millennials Must Watch. He dropped the new episode, or the first episode, debut episode, talking Ghostbusters, but that's for another day. Today, we are here to talk about this awesome new animated series from Rooster Teeth called Genlock, starring Michael B. Jordan, Dakota Fanning,
David Tennant, Maisie Williams. It's a star-studded pack cast, and as well as they have a bunch of them, because they also have another show on their network called RWBY, which is their big hit, and this is their follow-up to prove that like they can make other content. Mm-hmm. They have a bunch of the voice actors from that show on there. They'll be on the show as well and making guest appearances or just using their voice for the show. So right off the back, that's the first thing we want to talk about is the cast. That's one thing that when I was watching the first episode, and we're going to talk about the second episode as well a little bit, but just we have Michael B. Jordan working alongside David Tennant, the voice acting amongst the cast, just the chemistry was incredible.
Yeah, all across the board, I agree. And the characters are very fully realized from the beginning. You get the idea of who is what their relationships are, what his relationship is with Dakota Fanning's character. Obviously, they're meeting right off the bat, and meeting the mom, all that kind of jazz. What's that family? The sister's introduced. We don't see the family come back in the second episode, so we don't know if the family dies in the New York attack or what's happening there.
We'll see that in like the later episodes. But like you said, just right off the back, within the first couple of minutes, they set up the world that we live, the world that he lives in, the family dynamic. Yep. It all felt so organic. So this takes place about 50 years into the future on Earth, and it's like the idea of what will we do with the technology if the future, like the technology, really came to life. What would people use it for? And then that's when we're starting to see these evil organizations and the people defending the Earth. And it's kind of like Pacific Rim meets Ghost in the Shell, but in an animated version.
Yeah, and this is an interesting new style of animation. It's not the typical anime that you've seen before, which I like. It's got a different kind of slower move to it. There are gaps in dialogue that are weird but you have to get used to the rhythm of how people interact. And they said, the creators said, they wanted to create a more like grounded anime series, right? Mm-hmm. And you get that, even though it's all sci-fi and it's 50 years in the future and there's nanotech and all that kind of stuff. It's the relationships and how that bleeds out into the technology and the sci-fi aspects of the show that really make the show interesting to someone like me.
Yeah, it's like a family first, grounded. These characters are the most important part first, and then it just happens to be a sci-fi related anime badass show. Yeah. And so we're going to talk a little bit about spoilers. So if you haven't watched the first episode, at least don't watch this. It'll be up on Rooster Teeth's website for free. The first episode is for free, and then you have to become a member to see the second episode, which I personally believe is worth it because it was fire. But
it is a good second episode.
So the middle of the first episode, we see Julian Chase actually perish.
Yeah.
Well, we think he's actually dead, but at the end of the episode, it's revealed he fades back and he's like, "What's up?"
Yeah.
And then it just goes. Like, we all knew he was going to come back because he's a main star.
It's Michael B. Jordan.
It's Michael B. Jordan. He's the main star of the show.
Episode. Yeah, exactly.
So, but just that whole reveal and then going into the next episode, how it took a little bit of a time jump. So in the next episode.
Four years later.
Mm-hmm. And then so I'm really excited to see how that plays into the storyline with his relationship with Miranda and how, like, because maybe they didn't show she probably moved on. It's been 4 years. So
We didn't see if she moved on with anyone else because they were just at that point where they were possibly gonna like take this thing to the next level. Their relationship. The sister jokes about, your sister-in-law coming to stay with you, and he's like, "What? Say what?" And so you see all that go down. Then he sacrifices himself to buy time for his family, for everybody else in New York, for his crew, his people, and then him coming back like this. And then there is a confrontation in the second episode between Miranda and Julian about like why this all happened. And we get more of David Tennant in the second episode.
Fantastic.
Maisie Williams is introduced in the second episode. We get this Japanese character, this Russian character gets thrown in. There's some espionage, a traitor. All this stuff gets thrown in. And so and the fight scenes in the second episode are incredible.
Hell yeah. I was just about to say that though. I was just sitting there. I was already in the zone. But once they were like, "Oh, it's about to go down."
Yeah.
Just him whipping the smoke. joke around, but the fight, like the actual fight scene when they were going up against each other, fantastic for just in general, but for animation itself, that looked crisp, incredible. Mm-hmm. Damn, like I was really blown away from that. Just it's interesting to see how they can do from we got this Mortal Kombat type fight style, but we also were in big ass Gundam type mechanisms and we're fighting, doing all that. So it works on all levels, which I think it has something for everybody.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think it does have something for everybody. It's a new style. It's a new approach to an animated series, and I like it. I'm immediately hooked. I'm going to be finishing the season as we go along. I don't know how many reviews we're gonna do. We're going to get to do, but like, I'd like to keep watching this and see where it takes me. And the reason is because of the relationships between the characters and what's happened, the friendships that Michael B. Jordan's character has, that Julian has with his boys and the crew there, but also the relationship with Miranda and how that progresses now that he's not physically able to do certain things. And so you're like, oh, what does this mean? And so that's what's so great about the show is their connection and their dialogue and their interactions.
And it's just so well done from like how we're talking about this, all the characters, all the relationships. We've only seen the first two episodes, and I'm just ready to just dive into the rest of the season. I think they're going to be releasing one or two episodes every week after the premiere this Saturday, which you'll be watching this review. But I'm really excited to see. Maybe we can come back and do a review in the mid-season, do a recap of the finale. But overall, I got to say, just blew my expectations. I knew it was going to be fire, but it's a tall order to come from their other show, RWBY, to deliver something as on the same level, maybe even better. And they knocked it out of the park with this one.
Yeah, I agree. This is certainly, it feels like Rooster Teeth leveling up here and kind of rising to the challenge of their desire to level up with this series.
Yes.
And not just the voiceover acting, the animation, the story they're trying to tell, the time and the patience that they are rolling the story out over the first two episodes, I enjoyed a lot as well. They don't need to just blurt it all out. Mm-hmm. It's a progression. And I love that scene. I know we got to wrap up soon here, but I love that scene with David Tennant and what happens with that traitor, what they try to do. They go, oh, yeah, so there is consequences for certain things. If you're not connected or the right physical or emotional makeup to connect to something, it can cost you. So
deadly.
There are consequences to everything going on in the world. I'd be curious to hear what people think as they watch the first episode and the second episode. Any last things you want to say?
No, I'm just going to say, like, give this show a chance. Yeah. Make sure to check it out on roosterteeth.com. I think the first episode is free. If you want to dive in, just test it out. Just go for it because it's something new, refreshing, and it has something for everybody, I think, and it works on multiple levels.
Yeah, you can do this on the roosterteeth.com. Memberships are available there for $4.99 a month on the iOS, Android, Xbox One, Apple TV. So you can do that and watch them there if you want. All right. Well, let us know what you thought when you watched those two episodes in the comments section below. Remember to like and share this video on your social media and subscribe to Collider for more reviews just like this. That's Dorian Parks. You can find him at
Dorian Parks and Rec on Twitter because Parks and Rec is better than The Office, but also make sure to watch Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
There you go. And you can find me at The Roca Says. We'll talk to you soon.